So hey guys, and welcome to another Retro Games for Cheaters with me, Supernautus. And today we are playing, or today we are also playing, because we did Batman Returns a little while ago, we're playing Animorphs Shattered Reality on PlayStation 1. Sorry, just checking things there. So this was released in 2000-ish, developed by SingleTrac. For Infogrames, I've never been 100% sure how you're supposed to pronounce that. It was a book series by Scholastic, I believe. That was made into the game. There were other games too. But yeah, this is one of them. So we're playing this with infinite lives and health, infinite time, and infinite turbo or something, I believe. So, without further ado, let's kind of get on with it, I guess. See where it takes us. Everything has changed.
The Yurk leader, Visor 3, gained control of a weapon powered by a continuum crystal. But the weapon was more powerful than expected. The crystal exploded. It shattered reality itself. Only one thing stands between the Yurk and ultimate victory. Young heroes called
brother. Okay, be even more careful. Skill.
Thank you.
Ugh.
looks fun. Hey!
What was that? I got right out of my bar.
Up. Oh, great. Nowhere to go but up. Crash helmet. Again.
Enough already.
What's in here? zoo at night. I don't want to save this rainforest. Ah! Some new boards would be really useful right here. Hey! What's this?
Ow!
This is some tree. Enough already. Like this underground stuff.
Ow!
again.
Next time, pick up somebody who will sack. Thank you. ready now.
Thank you. somebody your own size.
Hey!
So it would appear that that was Animorphs. Was it Animorphs? What, Shattered Dimensions or something? It was, in fact, Animorphs Shattered Reality, of course. I forgot what it was called. So what did I think of that? Well, the platforming was an absolute pain at times, especially the 3D sort of platforming, you know, when it was pretty much side-on, which almost felt like 2D because there wasn't really any directions you could go, that was alright. But as soon as you started having to jump in other directions and work out depth and all the rest of it, it just didn't seem to be very well done. The other thing that got me that I kind of laughed at was you obviously all turn into these different creatures, a tiger, a wolf, a bear, and a rhino, but a wolf pawing at somebody somehow does just as much damage as a rhino ramming into them. You know, just me. You know, it seems to me that should do more damage. Not that there were a lot of things we had to fight. With the infinite lives, yeah, that probably helped us with some of the stuff. With the infinite time, obviously we didn't have to worry about any time running out, and our infinite health meant that, like, the boss fight there we could do without too much difficulty. It's not a game I would necessarily say you must go out and play right now. But it's not the worst thing in the world, I suppose. Anyway, thank you very much for tuning in to another Retro Games for Cheaters with me, Supernautus. If you did enjoy what you're watching, please feel free to hit that like button, maybe add a subscription, and hit the notification bell for notifications. It'd be great if I could have some more follows. That'd be very nice. Thank you very much. Anyway, for now, thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.